So it was eighth grade, 192 pounds, a bundle of whatever, friendly, ambitious, and I guess full of life. From middle school to high school career, my biggest obstacle was my own inner conflict, my insecurity. It started when I noticed that I didn't have the admirable trait, you know, the six pack, the biceps and all that. You know, I had the brains, but my appearance was not satisfactory. I was just like this chubby little fat Albert with a little bit of heart. And then all of a sudden, I just evolved to a kid with pain and sadness. All I wanted, all I aspired to be was just confident. So I remember it was Thanksgiving. You know, I kind of overate, you know. I went upstairs to kind of like isolate myself, and I threw up for the first time. And then I checked my weight, because before I would never lose weight after working out. And then I finally saw that I lost some pounds, and I realized that that may be the method that I would take a part of. I felt like that was kind of the introduction to a roller coaster ride with this disorder, this monster. So I remember when, you know, the throwing up started to become a pattern. And when I looked behind, I saw my little sister, you know, 4 years old, and she saw me.
I looked in the toilet, and then it was throw up. And I was saying, and then I moved back.
But it was becoming a monster, but this creature that I was having this interaction with, and it was private, and it was something that it was close to me. And I remember one day I was doing my homework. I kind of had the urge, but then I rejected it. And it got really worse, because I just felt like this monster inside of me, it started to get more angry, and it started to throw things in my head, like, and it just it made it worse, and I felt like it was attacking me, and I felt like that I couldn't overpower it, and I felt like I had no agency over myself. It got to the point where I went to the train station, and bulimia, it takes a whole lot of your energy, and I didn't feel like I was with myself, and I didn't feel like I had enough balance, so I almost fell off the train station. And that's when I realized that this condition, this disorder, and this connection with this monster had to stop.
Barbara, I can help you. Go. I'm gonna protect you from the monster.
But what is?
Shut up!
But what happened?
Shut up! Shut up!
I felt like, you know, this issue of bulimia was a monster for me. I felt like there was someone hovering over me, something hovering over me. Definitely an inner demon that I had to control. I didn't feel like that I was in control of my own agency. It got to the point where I lost about 30 pounds, that low, like, it's really, really bony, skinny. And it started becoming troubling to my parents, and my mom was concerned, my dad was concerned, my sister was concerned. They used to cry for me.
Because if somebody cried, me and my brother and sister and my family cried, I will be sad.
It wasn't only my sister, it was basically a whole bunch of people. My counselor, my parents, my friends. And my sister was kind of the representation of all of that combined together, because without her telling my parents and without her informing my family members, I would have never been exposed to the idea that I was being hurt. I just looked at my insecurity right in the eye.
Please let me know. Take me to your river.